I'm Sydney.
And I'm Natalie. And this is BSPN.
Our Ben Salem varsity football team took on Council Rock South in an SOL showdown.
They were able to beat them 21-0. Now let's go over to Casey for some highlights of Ben Salem's victory.
And on Saturday, October 8th, the Ben Salem Owls took on the CR South Golden Hawks in a divisional match. CR South wins the toss and elects to receive to get things going. As you see on the screen going early, the Golden Hawks are stagnant as they try to get the run game going. As you see here, the Ben Salem defense is absolutely shutting them down. That was first down. We're going to show off second down. They're going to hand it off to the second running back, and he gets stuffed at the 33. So that was going to lead to a CR South punt, and Ben Salem's going to get things going on offense as Dreshawn Moore hands it off to Malcolm Carey up the gut for an 11-yard gain. But sadly, our offense would be just as stagnant. We would have to punt it away. The quarterback's going to try to pitch it to the wide receiver here, and he's going to be taken down for a 6-yard loss. So both offenses unable to get things going on early. It's going to be second and long here. He's going to go for a pass behind the line to Scrooge, but wait a minute. He is unable to make the catch, and he is taken down in the end zone, and that would result in a safety. So the Ben Salem Owls have a 2-0 lead over the Golden Hawks. And Keith Parrish, he's going to take this thing. He's going to take it up the middle, and he's going to continue to cut up. He has one man to beat. He's still running down the 10, the 5, and he's taken down at the 2-yard line. That's a big-time return that would set up in a Ben Salem Owls touchdown as Malcolm Carey walks into the end zone for the first touchdown of the day. And that would make an 8-0 score as Matt Corbett would sadly miss the extra point. So they are driving here. They're going to try another run play. But wait a minute. It is snagged out of his hands. Number 34 rips the ball out. And Ben Salem would have the offensive position at the 40-yard line. So Dreshawn Moore is going to take the snap. He's going to give it off to Dreshawn. No, wait a minute. He pitches it off to Keith Parrish. He's going to cut inside, cut back out. He's still running, juking out a man. He's going to be taken down at the 38-yard line. So another big-time play for Ben Salem is Dreshawn Moore. He's going to set up out of the gun. He's going to look for a man. The blocking will not hold up. He's going to try to juke out one man. He's going to do so. Gets a great block on the outside. He's still up. Wait a minute. Cuts two defenders, and it will be taken down at the 21-yard line. And that would be the start of the second quarter. And here we go. Dreshawn Moore, he's out of the pistol. He's going to take the snap. He's going to dump it right off to Keith Parrish. He gets it short in the backfield. It doesn't matter. Keith Parrish trucks over a man. He's still running. He will be taken down at the 11. So now, Dreshawn Moore setting up again out of the pistol. They're going to look for a man. They're going to dump it off to Keith Parrish again. He's going to cut to the 10-yard line. Cuts right back inside, fighting for more yards. And we take it down at the 1. So now, Dreshawn Moore has put them in a great position to score. Let's see what they do here. He's going to take the snap. He's going to hand it off right to Malcolm Carey as he walks right in for another touchdown, making the score 14-0 off the missed extra point. So now, CR South, they got a fight. They have 2 quarters left to play, but wait a minute. Fumble on the play, but it is recovered by CR South. So now they're going to hand it off once again, and he will get absolutely stuffed in the backfield, only for a 2-yard gain on that one. Then they're still on the field. CR South, you've got to look for another handoff, and he's immediately taken down. So now that would set up for Ben Salem on offense. That was a turnover. He's looking deep down the field. Keith Parrish for a touchdown, but wait a minute. Flag was on the play for holding, so it's taken back. Dreshawn Moore gives the handoff to Malcolm Carey as he is able to get a big-time gain on that one. Now Dreshawn Moore, he's out of the gun. He's alone. He's going to look for a man. He has no time in the pocket. Cuts a few men. He's still running. Jukes out 3 men. He's still running to the first down marker. And he will get the first down, but that would result in a turnover on downs after a few missed opportunities after the penalty. And then they go for the handoff right up the gun. He is taken out for a 1-yard stuff. So now they are continuously driving. Now they are at the Ben Salem 15. They're looking for a run with the QB, and he is taken down for a gain of nothing. So now CR South, he's still looking for a man. He's going to look for the pitch. He's absolutely destroyed in the backfield. And that would set up the turnover on downs. Dreshawn Moore, he's going to hand it off to Malcolm Carey, who makes a big-time run on that one. But sadly, they would have to punt since their drive stalled out. CR South, they're looking for a pass play. He is absolutely stuffed in the backfield for a 6-yard loss. Going to set up for second and long, and that would set up for another CR South punt. Ben Salem will retake possession. Dreshawn Moore jukes out a defender. He's continuing to run. He switches fields, and he will be able to run for almost a first down as he gets a 9-yard carry. And that would set up for the second half to start. The score is 14-0, and Bensale will have great field position here since of the result of the ball going out of bounds on the kickoff. So Deshaun Moore, he's going to take the snap. He's going to hit it right off to Malcolm Carey. Malcolm Carey just fighting through his own offensive line, get a big-time carry of 6 yards. So now that would set up for Bensale to sadly punt. CR South are going to try to hand it off right up the gut, and he will be taken down for a 2-yard gain. CR South again tried the handoff, and he is stuffed right in the backfield at the 40-yard line. And they are going to continuously try to drive down, and he will be stuffed in the backfield. There's a flag, and there was also a fumble, but CR South is able to recover. CR South again looking for the pass. He's looking deep. Bensale in perfect position, unable to grab the interception. Big time missed opportunity for Bensale. So CR South still somehow on the field. They are maintaining their offense, and the quarterback tries, but he is absolutely stuffed by Bensale's interior defensive lineman. But now Keith Parrish, he's on the end around. He's going to continue to run. This kid has speed, and he is taken down at the 40-yard line, but a penalty would take it back. Deshaun Moore, he's going to look for a man. He has Gerald. Wait a minute. Oh, risky throw, but a tight window that he was able to fit himself into to get down at the 30-yard line. Deshaun Moore hands it off to Malcolm Carey, who fights for another big-time gain of 15 yards. Deshaun Moore, he's going to take the snap. He's going to hand it off to Keith Parrish on the end around. Once again, they run that play a lot, and he gets a hard gain of 6 yards. Deshaun Moore, he's still going to look for something here. He's going to hand it off right to Malcolm Carey, who explodes up the middle. What a touchdown for Malcolm Carey. What a day. 3 touchdowns, and he is able to score. Matt Corbett boots it through the uprights to make it 21-0. In the third quarter. So now CR South, they're driving here, they're on the move, they need to score, see what they can do here. Another pass play, and he is taken down. No chance by the Bensale defensive lineman. So now again, CR South still trying to fight for some yards here, and he is absolutely stuffed for a gain of 2. Bensale has been playing great all day long. Now CR South, he's under center, he's taking the snap, it's a fumble, and Bensale will recover. What a play. Now Deshaun Moore has a chance to expand the lead even more. He's going to look for the QB read, and he's going to continue to run. He completely reverses fields, and he's able to get taken down at the 45-yard line. What a play by the junior. Now Deshaun Moore, he's in the pistol full house formation. He's looking for a pass. He has no one open. He's just going to run, and he's just going to continuously run down the right sideline. Jukes a few guys, and he is taken down at the 32. And after another big-time run by Deshaun Moore, that's going to set up for another first down. He's going to hand off right to Malcolm Carey, who stumbles on his back feet and tries to fight for a first down. What an effort, Deshaun Moore. He's going to take off the snap. He's going to give it right back to Malcolm Carey, who's been the safe guy all day long. He's been the safe bet for this offense, but they would have to turn it over on downs as they get a big-time sack in the backfield. What a play for Bensale. Big time momentum booster, but sadly they would drive all the way down the field. He tries to get one last second touchdown, and it would not pay off. Ladies and gentlemen, what a game. 21-0 for the Bensale Owls. And make sure you're coming out to every home game, and always remember, go Owls.
Morgan Cubitt takes the ball from the opponent while running and passes it to her teammates. Morgan Cubitt and Hannah Forrest prevent the ball from entering the net with their defense saves. Lauren Wada plays the ball to the whistle while trying to approach the net. Gabby Greco receives the ball and passes to teammate Katie Mulvey. The goalie Selena Lee stops the ball from entering the net.
I'm Emily.
And I'm Anastasia.
And today, the Bensalem girls volleyball team went against Truman for their second game.
This time, the game took place at Truman's home court, and you could tell the Truman girls wanted this win more than anything.
Whereas the Tigers put up a good fight, the Lady Owls ended up dominating the game 3-2.
Truman has immensely improved since the last match, but Bensalem never gave up. The players have said that this was the best game of their season.
That's all for today. Stay tuned for some highlights.
Just fine before I met you. I drink too much and that's an issue, but I'm okay. Hey, you tell your friends it was nice to meet them, but I hope I never see them again. I know it breaks your heart. Moved to the city and I broke down crying. 4 years, no calls. Now you're looking pretty in a hotel bar. And I can't stop. No, I can't stop. So baby, pull me closer in the backseat of your Rover.
You. I forgot just why I left you, it was insane. Say, play that Blink-182 song that we beat to death in Tucson, okay.
I know it breaks your heart, we moved to the city and I broke down my head. 4 years on call, still don't look pretty in a hotel room. And I can't stop. Oh, I can't stop.
So baby, pull me closer in the backseat of your Rover that I know you can't afford. Like that tattoo on your shoulder, all the sheets are off the corner. All the mattress that you saw.
Great serve by senior Sarah Zopp, scoring the team an ace. Amazing play by the Owls, allowing senior Maddie Sauer to get a kill. The Owls carry out a long, intense rally with great digs, sets, and hits, ultimately dominating and scoring the point. Great pass by Jess Wiley, causing a perfect set by Emily Cook, allowing Maddie Sauer to get a kill on the ball and scoring the winning point.
Hi, I'm Zach.
And I'm Lisa.
Today, the Bensalem Owls cross country team took their talents to the Tennant Invitational.
They competed against 60 schools.
The main contributors in this race were Akil Backus, who came in first place for the Bensalem with a time of 16:08.
Shortly following him was sophomore Tommy Brewer and junior Zach Backus, who both came in at a time of 16:28.
Justin Pratt and Thomas Bala finished off the race, which resulted in Bensalem placing 7th overall.
On junior varsity, the key runner, Carithian Rivera, medaled with a time of 17:50.
We wish the Bensalem Owls cross country team good luck at their next meet on Friday.
Here is varsity runner Thomas Bala. Here, sophomore Tommy Brewer is in the top 20. Here comes junior Zach Backus. Following Zach Backus is Tommy Oliver.
Hello, my name is Jimmy and this is OTN. On Friday, September 16th, our girls tennis team traveled out to Council Rock North. The girls fought hard against one of their mightiest opponents. Sadly, the girls were not able to get the win. However, here are some highlights from Friday's match.
John V hits a great return. Joyce helps out her partner Maya by hitting in fair. Marta hits a hard forehand to win the point.
What's up, Ben Salem? On October 7th, the boys' soccer team went against Council Rock North in a soccer match. However, the Owls lost 2-0. Great game, though, boys. Now let's check out some highlights.
Zola Maglory can be seen chasing after the ball. Many were frustrated, but senior Matt Corbett attempted to lighten their mood. After a hard-fought game, the boys line up and congratulate each other.
Senior Emily Pyle delivers a spike that flew like a butterfly and stung like a bee to the opposing team's side. Senior Emily Pyle sends the ball over the net and one opposing player tries to send it back over, but it just isn't enough as the ball lands on the opposing team's side anyway. Emily Pyle hits a spike, scoring Ben Salem another point.
Thank you.
Maddie Sauer perfectly placed the ball right inside the lines for an outstanding Ben Salem point, leaving Central Buck South guessing. Central Buck South stays alive but wasn't able to get the ball to the Ben Salem side, practically handing them the point. Ben Salem tries getting the ball over the net, but it comes back to them and they pass it to Central Buck South for a long play, but Ben Salem was still left with the win.
On September 17th, the Ben Salem Owls cross country team took their talents to compete in the George School Invitational.
With star runner Akil Backus ran a time of 16:27, putting him in fourth place overall.
Tommy Brewer went 18:08 to come second for the Owls.
Shortly behind Tommy was Justin Pratt, who came in at a time of 18:23.
Sophomore Thomas Bala came in with a time of 18:48 to put himself in fourth for the Owls.
Junior Elijah Rizzo came in with a time of 19:17, which made the varsity team come in fifth place overall.
For the girls, junior Simone Tan fought hard to race to come up with a time of 22:29.
Shortly following her was Patty Higgins, who came in shortly after Simone.
Overall, the Ben Salem Owls came into the race with full force and came out with amazing results.
We wish the Owls luck with the rest of their season.
Sophomore Thomas Bala hit his personal record today. Senior Akil Backus medaled at this meet in fourth place. Sprinter Kyle Keenan ran in his first cross-country race today. Senior Jeremiah Polk placed in seventh for the team. Shot putter Brandon Townsend also ran cross country today.
Students to your left and to your right, not only do they live here, they make this place go, and they make us look good. And you're going to see, you can see the accomplishments, and some of the accomplishments will get read to you from the Blue Program, and their advisors are going to share some personal stories and anecdotes and things that make these students so great. Okay, and I just want to say to the parents, thank you. Thank you for letting us, your son and daughter, probably more like 7 to 7, 7 to 8, 12, 13 hour days. And I know, you know, I appreciate it. They're in good hands, but they really make this place go. So we're going to kind of jump around. It's mostly seniors. We'll get our sophomore and junior in here and show them love, but it's mostly a senior day, so I'm going to be very proud. As 12th grade principal, we got best kids in the building. Best kids in the building, and I'm just looking forward to how far you guys go in life and your greatness, and then remember kind of where it started. It first started at home, and then secondly, hopefully, Ben Salem High School molded you into that greatness. So we're going to start off with our Community Service Club president, Evie Patel, and the advisor, Miss Reddy. And school board member, and also, I'll say co-advisor or assistant, Mr. Cohen, thank you.
Good morning, everybody. I am really, really pleased to present Hedvi Patel. She was elected president of Community Service Club last spring, and she jumped right in to being a leader. She was involved in the Rotary Club at Creekside, which I'm hoping Mr. Cohen will talk more about. She helped with moving the people at Creekside. Fall Fun Day was happening. She was involved in that. She worked with the Relay for Life. Some of these events even occurred after school was out in June. She said, nope, I'm going to work on this. I'm going to be a leader. She did wonderfully. We've been doing the PTG meetings at FALS. She's been working on that. She did Bark for Life. Hopefully a lot of you came out last weekend. We did the Ben Salem Fall Festival. She was instrumental in helping all of the Community Service Club members to learn how to make balloon animals, how to do face painting. It's one of our big events that we love to do, Fall Festival. I hope you guys were able to enjoy that. We've got some great events coming up soon that she's going to be helping them with again, and I'm hoping Mr. Cohen will tell us some of those events.
Thank you. I'm Mark Cohen from Ben Salem Rotary. On behalf of Ben Salem Rotary and our high school Interact Club, I want to thank Hedvi for her service. At the end of last year, Hedvi volunteered to help move furniture and belongings out of apartments at Creekside for the Bucks County Housing Authority. Also, at the end of the year, Hedvi and the Community Service Club raised money for the Advocates of the Homeless, raising all the money needed to provide green vegetables for the whole year. This year, Hedvi, as president of Community Service Club, will help our Rotary Club raise money for our pancake breakfast. The money will be used to provide Thanksgiving baskets for 200 families in Ben Salem. We also will be raising money again for Advocates for the Homeless and are planning another Rotary project with the Community Service Club. As a school board member, I'm proud of her. She is a great example of kids in our district, and I know Ms. Reddy and I are very proud of you. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I'd like to thank my mom for always supporting me. I'd also like to thank Ms. Reddy for nominating me for Student of the Month and being advisor for the Community Service Club. It is by no means a small club, and Ms. Reddy gives us officers a lot of freedom to try our own ideas and methods. I'd also like to thank Mr. Cohen for supporting the Community Service Club and allowing us the opportunity to volunteer with the Rotary Club. And lastly, I'd like to thank my fellow officers, Pooja, Kevin, and Jolly, for as running the club is truly is a team effort. As president of the Community Service Club, I have learned that running this club is a lot more than just signing people up for events. It focuses a lot on communication, whether it be between me and Ms. Reddy, the officers, or most importantly, the members of this club. As a leader, I have experienced that being the president isn't just taking initiative in the club, but also taking initiative in our local community in order to leave a positive impact, whether it be making balloon animals to make kids happy or attending fundraiser events for the American Cancer Society. Thank you.
Yeah. So on that note, we are going to segue into Varsity Club. Ms. Fisher is our advisor for Varsity Club, and our president is Peace Senkungu.
Good morning, everyone. This is Peace. Peace is with Varsity Club for our president this year. I had the pleasure of having Peace in geometry 2 years ago, and she was an excellent student then. Varsity Club is for varsity athletes, students who have already earned two varsity letters at some point in time in their high school career. And Peace has done that. She is a very busy person. She's ran cross country, she's done outdoor track, she's done swimming, as well as other activities like yearbook, powder puff, multicultural club, reading Olympics, and also part of NHS. So she's a very busy person, but I look forward to working with her. And already this, she started off, probably in about August, letting me know what her thoughts were, what she wanted to do, when can we get started. She's already planning out the year. So I look forward to working with her. She's very diligent and very on top of things. And I look forward to a great school year. Thank you. Peace.
Good morning. I'm so thankful to be able to serve as the president of Varsity Club. I would like to thank Mrs. Fisher for advising a club that honors student athletes and provides an opportunity for them to serve the Ben Salem community. This is done through volunteering at the snack stand for basketball games and at wrestling matches. Our biggest project is Adopt a Child in December. Athletes raise money or use their own to buy gifts for children in need during the holidays. Growing up as the oldest child of three, I have learned to be a role model and apply it to other areas in my life. My commitment, positive attitude in Varsity Club will be instrumental in encouraging members to be involved. A leader is someone who thinks of others before someone else. At the beginning of the year, I started to think of fundraising ideas. When I heard about the BHS Sports Association spaghetti dinner, I thought it would be the perfect opportunity for our club to make ourselves known to the Ben Salem community. Next Thursday, we will be selling t-shirts, bracelets, and keychains. Lastly, I would like to thank my parents for being there for me and instilling in me a hard work ethic in academics and sports. Thank you.
Ms. Scalero is our junior class president, but she's going to speak for Chloe, our sophomore class president, and Ezzy, our junior class president. So first, I'd like to call up Ms. Scalero.
Hi, my name is Karen Scalero, and I teach here. I am extremely proud to work at Ben Salem because I've lived here my whole life, and I graduated from here. But what I'm most proud of are the students that go here and that I get to spend time with every day. Chloe and Ezzy, you are two of them, and I get to see them on multiple occasions because I coach mock trial and I'm a class advisor. So I see you work tirelessly and endlessly all of the time just for the benefit of your classmates, and it's amazing. It is something that I look up to and I admire. I hope other students can take after. This week is homecoming prep week, which is crazy for all of us. You guys have spent hours and hours after school when you didn't have to, when you have classes of your own, helping with artwork and setting things up and making it fun for everybody, whether we're listening to High School Musical songs and dancing around and painting, or whether we're mock trial prepping at Meg's house for hours. You guys are dedicated and hardworking. You're reliable and dependent. You're the exact type of students that we have at Ben Salem that I'm extremely proud of. So congratulations, because you guys deserve it.
First, I'd like to thank my advisors. Well, technically, Ms. Scalero isn't our sophomore advisor, Mr. Morantz is, but I'd like to thank him, and I also like to thank her for mock trial, which is something I participate in, and it was one of the best experiences I had last year. And that also goes along with teamwork, because the students really have to come together and create something that they all have to participate, and if one person doesn't, then we don't really get along very well. Yeah, it doesn't really work out. And that's like the same thing with becoming like president of the class, because you can't do everything on your own and you have to have everyone come together and do it with you. And like homecoming week, like we
like without everyone helping, we wouldn't have gotten to do anything because we have to literally fill a banner like from here to like over there. So we really need help with that, and that's one of the great things is seeing teamwork. And even though not everyone like agrees with what you do, sometimes you just have to realize that like you can't please everyone, and that you just have to do what is like, I guess, utilitarianism, just what's the best for the class. And yeah, so I'd like to thank Ms. Scalero, Mr. Morantz, Ms. Linkhorst, and Ms. Paragula, and I'd also like to thank my parents. My dad isn't here, but my mom is, and she's constantly taking me back and forth between work, school, like clubs, so I'd just like to thank her for helping me out with that. Right, thank you.
Hello everyone and good morning. As Mr. Purr just mentioned, I am the junior class president and I have been so since freshman year. So freshman year starting out, it was our first year at Bensalem, but it was also our advisor's first year at Bensalem. Ms. Lamb and Ms. Claro both started teaching that year, so it was definitely a year of a lot of trial and a lot of error because we had to sort of make out the class activities by ourselves. But they really did help us and they guided us to have a great start to our high school career, and I really do thank them for that. And they really like they put up with our shenanigans all the time. As Ms. Clarell just said, while we were making our art for homecoming, we were blasting High School Musical and we were fooling around, but we still got it done, and I really thank them for that. And as we all have here, we all have a family foundation at home, so I'd really like to thank my parents for that. Every day they strive to push, they push me to strive for the best every single day, and they're the reason why I'm here today. And I would also like to acknowledge the class of 2017. I look around and I see people that I call my friends, and I'm really proud of them. They have set a really good foundation of what my class can look to for leadership. So Stas, DJ, Hebby, Amy, Peace, Parmita, Sinana, like everyone in here, I really like to thank them for how they have set leadership goals for the class of 2018. Thank you.
Our next club is Building Bridges. I'm going to ask Mr. Han to come on up here with me for a minute. He's a fan favorite. So, unfortunately, Mr. Morris couldn't make it today, so he asked me to speak about Ryan. And I'm going to be honest, I don't know a whole lot about Ryan, but I do have some great notes from Mr. Morris. But what I do want to talk about is Building Bridges, because I do know that program. And for Ryan Hunt to be the president or captain of Building Bridges is going to speak volumes. Building Bridges is a program where Mr. Hunt and about 100 other students here at the high school every Wednesday leave school about last period and go down to Schaefer and Snyder and talk to the kids about social issues, from bullying, and it runs the gamut to all kinds of topics, including even suicide. And we all know how important middle school is. It's those transition years from elementary to high school, and you really don't know who you are, and you haven't found your way yet, and life's very confusing, and you're introduced to new things. And for these students to go down there and talk to those students, because we know kids rather hear from their peers than they hear from us, especially people like me. I'm old and don't know what I'm talking about anymore. So, but to hear from Ryan and his classmates, because Ryan's cool, and Ryan's a senior at Bensalem High School. And as I talk about his accomplishments and all the cool things he does, the middle school kids look at him with big eyes like, oh, that's how you should act, and that's what you should do, and that's how you should handle a situation. So I'm obviously a big fan of Building Bridges, okay? One of my favorite programs here at the high school, but about Ryan. First and foremost, Mr. Morris told me Ryan received the Ian O'Malley Award at Schaefer Middle School. So then I hear that, and I hear Captain Building Bridges, and I already think this kid's aces, and he could probably do no wrong in life. Ian O'Malley, both of his parents were longtime educators, 35 plus years in this district, and Ian was a young teacher at Schaefer, tragically lost in a car accident. But if you talk to the staff at Schaefer and you talk to the students, and I believe they just graduated about 2 years ago, Mr. O'Malley's former students, they talk about it, his character and his energetic attitude, and again, like these students, a teacher that got there early and stayed late, coached multiple sports, got involved in multiple activities and started clubs, and was just there for the kids. And for you to be named out of all the students at Schaefer Middle School, the Ian O'Malley Award, that's prestigious. And then you're now captain of building bridges. So you are, as we spoke about, kind of destined for greatness and to do big things. But since I'm sure your parents are hearing me brag about you, Ryan has been in ROTC for 2 years, baseball for 3 years, golf team for 2 years. He is now captain of building bridges. In his second year, he is in KBG, which is Kick Butts Generation, an anti-smoking program, also run here at the high school. He's involved in Blue Gray, which next will be SJA, Ms. Kramer. Honor roll throughout high school, distinguished honors, 3.5 GPA. Okay, impressive young man. And my gift to you today is that I was going to play in the faculty golf game versus the students, and I was probably going to go against Mr. Hun, but my gift to you today is I'm not going to play. All right, so you can get another win today and feel great about yourself. And I am lucky because I might be the worst golfer ever. So on that note, I'd like to introduce Mr. Ryan Hun.
All right, thank you, Mr. Purr. I'd like to thank Mr. Morris for nominating me for this prestigious award. My mom's almost crying. It's all good. It's an honor to be the Building Bridges captain. Any way to affect the youth of our community is a big part for me. All the seventh graders and middle schoolers, like, that's their year where they're learning the ropes, and for me to help them learn the ropes and, like, show them the right way, it's a big part of me, and it's an honor. I know Morris since seventh grade, and he's always been pushing me and trying to do my best, and I respect him so much. He's a great guy, and don't want to make it too long, but to wrap things up, I'd like to thank my mom. Cry, mom, cry. It's all right, let the tears. I like to thank my mom, my dad, everything pushing me harder, my little sister for being annoying, but that's what little sisters are for. Aunt Kim's here, she gives the best Christmas presents, so that's always pushing me. So, thank you, it's an honor.
And our leader of SGA is Ms. Kramer, so I like to call it Ms. Kramer, and she is going, as she nominated our president, Anastasia Dyack.
Good morning. My name is Michelle Kramer, and along with Mrs. Meyer, Mrs. Cantwell, and Mr. Garska, I am an advisor of student government. This morning we are honoring Anastasia Dyack as our president. Student government, or SGA, is responsible for many school-wide activities, including Blue Gray in the spring, our annual canned food drive, which services the Bensalem community. We run that in November. And Red Ribbon Week, which is at the end of this month. In turn, we look forward to having Anastasia on board to help organize details, delegate duties, and motivate the student body to participate. With her friendly and welcoming personality, we have no doubt she will lead our school in a positive way this year. Personally, I have the privilege of teaching Anastasia every day, first period in AP Calculus, which we missed today. Okay. Do your homework. Okay. She is well respected by her peers and articulates her ideas quite well, even in the academic setting. pardon me. It's no surprise to me that Anastasia was voted the SGA president by the entire student body. So just a little bit different from other clubs, the entire school votes for the student government officers. So that's quite an accomplishment. It's also not surprising to me that she intends to apply to Princeton University and get good news back and be on the Princeton campus next school year. We look forward to a fabulous year with a fabulous president.
Good morning, everyone. First, I would like to thank my incredible parents who have given me so much. They have given me everything that they possibly could have. When we immigrated here, they had to sacrifice everything for my sister and I, and I would just like to take this time to thank them and say how incredibly grateful and blessed I am for every opportunity that I have thanks to them. I appreciate them more than anything. Secondly, I would like to thank all of my amazing advisors, Mrs. Kramer, Mrs. Meyer, Mrs. Cantwell, and Mr. Garska. They take so much time out of their own lives to ensure that Bensalem is full of spirit and is just an enjoyable environment to be in. We have countless spirit days, so many different events, and it's thanks to these advisors that everything is possible. Without them, school would not be as enjoyable as it is. Blue Gray would have to be the biggest event that takes place in Bensalem High School, and it's because of Mrs. Meyer, Mrs. Kramer, and Mr. Grosser, and all of the other advisors that it's able to be what it is. Even though during that time we all get really frantic, so much is going on, they are kind of that backbone that makes us accomplish what we do during that event. Lastly, I would like to thank all of my fellow officers, Matt, Emily, Julianne, and SGA, as they put in immense hard work to spread spirit throughout Bensalem. Thank you.
I'd like to call Mr. Bogan. His program or his club is so big, he has two presidents, and one of them is Parmita Patel, and the other one, my big test of the day, is Sunaina Srivastava. I passed? All right. And these two young ladies are his co-presidents of Multicultural Club, and Mr. Bogan is going to come up and speak about them.
Good morning. Ms. Calero, I can top what Mr. Purr said. I had the opportunity to know Mr. Purr before Mr. Purr was born. That shows you how old I am, so I've been here for a long time. I am very proud to introduce these two young ladies. Our club is very big. We have two officers. We have two officers for every position. But one of the things I'm proud of is that we have a large number of students. I do have a lot of programs we perform, but I'm also kind of demanding. I want our kids to be able to stand up, to do things, to go out and be leaders. And I run a very tight ship. But the pleasant thing I had about this year, these two young ladies really took over my reins and made it easy for me, and they really run a tight ship. I'm a student-oriented club. They run everything. They do everything. I'm there as an advisor. Ms. Rosenberg is my co-advisor. So I give them the responsibility to more or less go out there and lead. I also allow them to, they come to me and run things through me, and I have certain things that have to be done a certain way, but I leave it up to these young ladies to do that job. I'm gonna talk about them individually very briefly, then I'm gonna let them talk. Parmita, this is our first year. We have an application process. I don't allow the students to vote. They have to submit an essay. They have to get 5 recommendations for teachers. They have a good GPA and be a good student in good standing. So Parmita did a very good job with her essay. She also did a kind of an interview that you might see on The Apprentice. She came with a PowerPoint presentation why she should be the president. She cornered me in a room and spoke to me for about 20 minutes. I do mean cornered me. She was very to the point, very professional. I was very well impressed. She did a great job. Sunaina is a little different. Sunaina has been my president the last 2 years. Sunaina is a very, very good leader. Sunaina is very demanding. She organizes everything. If you had a chance to come to our town show last year, she's the one that got everything rolling for us. She did a great job. Like I said, I don't really want to talk a lot. I'm going to let them talk. I just want you to know they're great kids, great leaders, great students, and I'm very proud to have them as my co-presidents this year. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Hey, so I am Sunaina, like Mr. Bogan said, and I would like to start off by thanking my parents because they are the people that made me, basically, and they made me a well-rounded individual that I am today. And then I would like to thank Mr. Bogan and Mrs. Rosenberg for choosing me as the president again. And I remember I was standing here last year second-guessing myself whether I should be the president of this club, and today I can say that I am glad that I chose this path because it has transformed me as an individual. I have matured, I think I want to say. I was a very naive girl when I was in 9th and 10th grade, and then it has just made me the strong girl that I am today with so much opinion about everything. And this is not so much about me as it is about my club that I represent. I am just representation. It's the club that is the major part, the major thing. And I would like to just address an issue that I have noticed. I know it's not a major issue, but over the years we have seen
decreasing amount of students participating in clubs. And I would like to propose us all to be the medium that gets our voice to the kids, because the major reason that they aren't participating is because of lack of awareness. It's because they don't know what's going on, and we are the people that can get to them, that can explain to them that, hey, this is what's going on. It's not just about my club, it could be about everyone else's club too. And with that being said, I would like to invite you all to Around the World, which is on October 27th. It is a Thursday. It starts at 4 p.m. in the cafeteria, and Around the World is basically celebrating the cultural awareness in Bensalem High School. I'm very proud to acknowledge that over the two past years, our club has grown so much that we now represent majority of the cultural diversity that exists in our Bensalem High School, and I am very proud of that. And besides Around the World, I would also like to invite you all to the Talent Show, which is all student run. Every single person in our club is working hard to put on a show, and it actually shows teachers and parents actually acknowledging the fact that, hey, students, we understand that you'd work hard in the classrooms, but we also want to acknowledge the fact that you work hard outside of classrooms too. With that being said, that is all. Thank you. And of course, I would like to thank Parmita. I totally forgot about her. She is a great partner. It's very tough at times, and she has always helped me push forward and have a positive attitude towards our club. Thank you.
Good morning. Thank you, Sanana. I would like to thank Mr. Bogan for nominating me for this award. As a co-president of the Multicultural Club, we're asked to do many vigorous tasks that Sanana and I have undertaken, and we want to enhance this club even more through the upcoming years before we graduate by holding events as Around the World at the Talent Show. So we want to leave like a long-lasting impressions on the underclassmen that we have. Lastly, I'd like to thank my parents for always supporting me and encouraging me to the best that I can be. Thank you.
Our next recipient of Student of the Month will be our senior class president, who I've gotten to know over the last 2 years since I followed him since 10th grade. I call him DJ or Barack since he's our president, but Dwayne Hamilton, I guess I can only use that nickname for like another 6 weeks or so, and then you'll be DJ Hillary or DJ Trump, but we'll figure that one out later. So I'd like to call up Ms. Sibley and Mr. Sally. They're your hard-working senior class advisors and our class president of the senior class, DJ Hamilton.
Hi, I'm Ms. Tiselli, and this is Mrs. Sibley. We are the senior class advisors. First of all, I wanted to say, way to go, seniors. Congratulations to every single one of you. This is the first of the last of many things, okay? This is going to be your last student of the month as a president, okay? We're going to go through the year, and we're going to say, this is going to be the last of this. Get used to it, okay? We've had DJ as our class president for 4 years, which means we also came in with DJ, at least my first year at the high school, where as a freshman we were running around trying to figure out what was going on. We were kind of attached at the hip because I didn't know what was going on either. Sibley and I are trying to figure things out, and what's amazing is by the time you get to senior class, they become an extension of you, and they are the ones that are delegating. We are the ones that are reminding them what we have to do, but they are the ones that are saying, don't we have to do this, and now let me tell this person this. You guys talked about delegation. You guys talked about family involvement. You guys talked about teamwork. Every single person in here represents their team, represents their group, and DJ definitely represents us in our class. Some people might call him bossy, but I'm going to tell you what, the group of kids that works with him listens to him. So on one hand, you can call him bossy, but if they're going to listen to you and they're going to go to you and ask you questions and they're going to follow your instructions, then you are really a true leader. We were joking around last week that I can imagine DJ in first grade bossing people around with the blocks, and then they started telling us little anecdotes about the years with DJ. And this group of kids really has grown up together. They're used to him. They they love him, and as a result, we are more productive in 4 years than I've ever seen, and that's because he's been able to connect with more people every year, and he gets people involved. One last thing that I want to say, somebody mentioned how you guys reach out to different groups. DJ gets along with every single type of group of kid in this school, and that says a lot for him. That says a lot about what's going to happen in his future and what kind of job he can get into, and that says a lot. He can reach out to different groups, and we have a great senior class who gets involved in so many things. Proud to have never taught you, but to be able to experience you and all the things that you do in school. Thank you, DJ.
So first and foremost, I'd like to thank my family for giving me the strength and the encouragement to continue on this journey, whether it's by listening to dilemmas that we encountered at meetings or by motivating me to do more to help other students. In addition, I'd like to thank Mrs. Sibley, Mr. Selly, and the other officers of the Activities Club for knowing exactly how to handle me when I'm stressed out about anything right now, specifically because of homecoming decorations. Lastly, I would like to thank my class for believing in my leadership skills and voting me class president for the past 4 years. As president of the Activities Club, I believe the most important thing that I do is discern the talents that each person possesses. This in turn allows people to truly enjoy supporting their class, and nothing is more important to me than that. Being president for the past 4 years has been one of the greatest experiences of my life, and I would not trade it for anything. Thank you.
Thank you, DJ. Our last club we're recognizing today is National Honor Society. Our president, Amy Ma, I don't want to talk because I'm going to take Ms. Tressel's speech away, but she is the best. Okay, I'm just going to leave it that simple sentence. She's the best. All right, I'm going to let Ms. Tressel brag about her. She just has that R about her. When you have a conversation, you talk to her, and you're like, you feel like you're talking to, you know, a seasoned vet, you know, someone that's been in, whether it doesn't matter what field it is. I know she wants to maybe be a doctor, but doctor, lawyer, president, it doesn't matter. She's been doing it for 20 years, and you feel like you're talking to someone that's 35 and 40 years old with multiple degrees and has multiple experiences. And then you realize, like, wait, she's still in high school. Okay, she's definitely smarter than me. Why? Because they're going to say that's not hard. But she is great. So I won't, like I said, I won't steer a speech, Ms. Tressel. I'd like to call up Ms. Tressel, who runs our National Honor Society, and the president, Amy Ma.
Good morning. Before I read my prepared speech about Amy, I just wanted to kind of observe that, while gentlemen, I'm really proud of your accomplishments, DJ and Ryan, if you look around, there are a lot of strong women in our midst. I'm proud to be associated with HETV and Peace and Amy and NHS, a really strong triumvirate. And if they're an example of what Ben Salem can produce, I'm really proud to be a member of the Ben Salem community. So just to kind of follow up what Mr. Purr had said about Amy, I have the enviable responsibility of introducing you to Amy Ma. I'd like to speak not so much of her accomplishments, of which there are many, but more about her spirit as a person. She's a strong young woman, as I've said, and she's a representative of Ben Salem. In my 30 years of teaching, I've met many outstanding students, both young men and young women. I've nominated many students for the honor of Student of the Month, and still I can state unequivocally that Amy is the finest example of what Ben Salem aspires to be. Amy is a positive and upbeat role model. Amy takes on each task that she seeks to accomplish with both efficiency and cheerfulness. I've never seen Amy less than dynamic and positive. Amy serves as president of NHS while she maintains a GPA of at least a 4.2. Higher than that? However, she leads by committee, fairly and equitably dividing up the duties among not only her officers, but all of the Honor Society members. And sadly, this year, there aren't as many as we would like to have. We're having a membership, let's say, turnover coming up shortly, so we should increase that membership by at least 50. But the members that she does have actively involved, she divvies up the responsibility among them. Her positive outlook is felt by everyone she comes in contact with, and she transmits that energy to others so that you can come away from any encounter with her feeling more upbeat about yourself. Amy is a volunteer at Thomas Jefferson Hospital. She tutors at Ben Salem Public Library. She's dynamically involved in her community. Amy embodies diversity, and just recently she was telling me of her participation in a unique cultural event. Was it GARBA?
Yep.
GARBA? That was held right here at Ben Salem High School over the weekend. She said she danced and she celebrated with her friends. So just to kind of give you an idea of the type of person that Amy is. Amy was my nominee for Teen Volunteer of the Year Award, and while she didn't win that award, I'm certain she will go on to win many more prizes and awards this year and throughout her upcoming career. Keep an eye out for Amy. She's already made Ben Salem proud and will continue to do so. It's my privilege to honor Amy Ma as the Ben Salem Chapter of the National Honor Society Student of the Month Award. Congratulations.
Good morning, everyone. It's a pleasure and honor to stand in front of you this morning. I'm very proud to be president of the National Honor Society here at Ben Salem High School and be Student of the Month. As president of NHS, I have responsibilities of leading weekly meetings, writing agendas, recruiting new members, coordinating events, informing members, promoting collaboration and innovation, maintaining the code of conduct, and the four pillars of National Honor Society: scholarship, leadership, service, and character. And serving the needs of our community here in Ben Salem. So I would like to thank our principals, Mr. Purr, thank you for your amazing introduction for me. Very humbled. Our National Honor Society advisors, Mrs. Trussell and Mrs. Small, Dr. Lee and the school board members, as well as representatives for Ben Salem. Our teachers, I have a lot of teachers here, so yeah. My family, my mom and grandma are here, so thank you for always supporting me and hugging me, and you know, I know there's some down days where I'm like stressed out and you just calm me down very nicely and tell me everything's gonna be okay. And my friends, who a lot of you are actually here today, so yeah. And I will work harder to serve our high school and community as best as I can as president of National Honor Society and also just as a student here. So thank you very much for your support.
I'd like to introduce State Representative Jean DiGirolamo.
So again, I want to congratulate you. Continue to do what you're doing, and don't let anybody tell you that you can't accomplish what you want to accomplish if you put your mind to it and work really, really hard. And finally, I just want to thank everybody here with the school district, Dr. Lee, Bill Ferreira, the administration, for the wonderful work that you do with our children here in Ben Salem Township, and especially to the teachers. We should, many times, you know, it appears that public education is under attack here in Pennsylvania for some reasons once in a while. I just don't understand it. We should honor and value our teachers because they just do a phenomenal job in educating our young people. Thank you. Absolutely. Thank you and God bless. Good to be with you.
I'd like to call up our mayor, Mayor Joe DiGirolamo.
Born, raised, I've been here my whole life, so it's been a great, great community, and it only happens because of you guys. I tell everybody, it starts with the school district. The school district has to be turning out the youngsters that people want to live here and educate their children. So that's what's important here. The school district, we try to do our job as an administration at the township level, can't do it without you. But I thought I'd take another 20 minutes to speak since they stole all my lines. But anyway, I really want to thank you from the bottom of my heart, and I saw some tears from parents when their children came up here, and I just can't think of the joy. And by the way, we have some grandmoms here, don't we? I know we have a grandma here. And congratulations to you all. Look forward to coming back next month. This was a wow, by the way, to start off the school district. God bless you, everybody.
And the man I'm going to call up, and you know, obviously he has titles, Superintendent, Dr. Lee, but I venture to guess his favorite title is Proud Parent. So I'd like to call up Dr. Lee.
So congratulations. Thank you for all you do for us. I often take advantage of opportunities at events like this to triangulate our performance and our work products. And I'm speaking simply and solely in business terms. So we all walk out of these events saying, man, we do a pretty good job. And you are the prime example. We have a lot of work to do, right? We all do, and we'll continue. But we've got a great foundation. We have great spirit here. Congratulations. Thanks for being part of this wonderful event. And it's a good week to be an owl, right? Bonfire, couple wins to look forward to. Good luck, Al. Good back.
I had the opportunity, and Dr. Lee talked about our mission and how we're judged by some people. And we have a young lady sitting amongst us who has received a commended student award from the National Merit Scholarship Corporation. And what that means is this young lady has scored a certain score on the PSATs. Out of the thousands of people across the country who take the PSATs, she was recognized as having one of the top scores. So on behalf of the faculty and administration, I would like Kethi Patel to come up and receive her award. I would like to talk to you about leadership. And a leadership is something that is thrust upon some people because of the office they hold. And other times, it's an unwanted burden for some people. But leadership's when you accept that role, and congratulations to all of you for accepting that role. So congratulations once again. Best of luck in your leadership roles. Please continue after you leave Bensalem to seek those roles, because as somebody said, you're at a great place, and if you're a leader here, you can be a leader anywhere. Thank you and have a great day.
On October 1st, Bensalem hosted their annual Fall Festival. During the festival, there's a car show held where family and friends can walk around and look at the different cars of their different years, along with their unique engines, interiors, and awards.
Put a spell on you.
I'm Jordan here with OTN, and this is Lou Farinow. Now, this is your car, correct?
Yes, it is. This is a 69 Mercedes-Benz 280 SL, manufactured in Germany. It's got a 2.8-liter straight-six mechanical fuel injection engine with a four-band radio and a four-speed automatic transmission. It's known as the Pagoda. It has actually a hard top that they're not showing today that has a distinctive Pagoda shape to it.
Ah, very impressive. So what impressed you most about this year's car show?
This is a nice family event. These are mostly locals that are coming up with their cars and bringing them to this event. I like how it's close by. This is our neighborhood's car show, and that's what impressed me the most about it.
Ace is Sergeant McGinty's second dog, and McGinty works for the narcotics unit for the canines. Ace is trained in patrol and will soon be trained in narcotics detection. Canine unit dogs are trained to not let go or cease pursuing the suspect unless a verbal command has come from the trainer. Argo has worked 9 years and will be retiring this year from the canine unit. Leo is the youngest of the group, just under 2 years old, and just graduated from the K-9 Academy. Canine unit dogs are trained to attack with the well-being of just not the trainer, but the physical well-being of the suspect in mind. Chief is Corporal Cowden's third police dog. They both serve as narcotics detection and patrol. Corporal Cowden takes Chief around all three houses to find the suspect. Chief has been given a sample of what the suspect smells like and will try to find him in one of the three houses.
Distributors. We're located right here in Ben Salem. We come out to your home or business, very economical and super reliable. We've been in the township almost forever now, so if you need a computer repair, we're the one.
Can you tell me your names and who you're with?
I'm Buster with DCI Comfort. We're on Route 13 in Ben Salem.
One thing is, how long have you been coming to help out with Pride Day? How long have you been doing this?
8 or 9 years, and we really like it because we get to see a lot of our customers. A lot of people come back every year and say hi, get some free t-shirts, so it's, we really enjoy it a lot.
Okay.
It's a great day. Glad we got the weather all down for us.
You don't just see the customers at their house, we get to see them outside their environment.
And one of the most important questions, what's some of the stuff that you do?
We do heating and air conditioning. We also deliver heating oil. But we make people comfortable.
Okay. And I see we have a surprise guest.
Green Man.
Ah.
The kids really like seeing him, getting pictures with him.
How many years have you been coming to Pride Day?
For the last 15 years, we've been here. We're home based out of Bristol Borough, the Amish market. Family owned company. Original recipe, just like Grandma used to make.
Out of all the years that you've been coming here, what's like something interesting or like a bit that's just happened that's like can't happen
the
anywhere?
Community. I mean, everybody gets along. I mean, it's a great place. A lot of great people. Fireworks at night, I mean, you guys do a great job. I mean, you guys bring out the police, the firemen, EMS, the community, and everyone comes together, and I think it's fantastic. Ben Salem's a great place to be. We're proud to be here.
Okay. How do you feel like today's going to be?
You know what? Even though the clouds are here, it doesn't matter. We're all going to have a good time anyway. It's going to be a fantastic day. We'll see you here.
Okay.
1,000 smiles in every bag.
First off, can you say who you are and what you're with?
Okay, I'm Ralph Douglas, 2SNO Douglas, and I'm here with Just for the Kids.
Just for the Kids!
And this is PJ, Fred, and we're here selling hot dogs to raise money to do all the things that we do in the classroom for Just for the Kids. Pride Day, as we've been doing Pride Day since I guess it started. Just for the Kids is now celebrating 20 years since 20 years.
Yeah.
Well, last weekend we had a great color run at Schaefer Middle School. And the next thing's coming up, of course, today, and then we have a 20-year celebration dinner coming up, and then in the spring we do a bowl-a-thon. So there's a cut.
Do you think today's going to be a great day? Do you think you don't care about the weather, just going to have fun and stuff?
That was kind of scary. You're right. With the weather like it is, but we've been turning out hot dogs left and right.
Well, how we doing? All right. So, come on, so. There's myself. All right, so. All right, now this next young lady coming out, she's a little Mimi right here. Z girl. Come on, Jers. Hey, Jers, there you go, Jers. Over here, Jers. Hey, Jers, over here. There you go, Jers. Next fella coming out here, this guy's wound tighter than a drum, I'm telling you. Eli. Now this next young lady coming out of here, Lulu. Come on, Lou. There you go, Lou. All right, everybody there? All right. Hey, now. You ready for him? Here comes Monkey! Monk! That's crazy old Monk there. Now this next fella coming out, and his name is little old Birdie. There he is, little old Birdie right there. Doesn't he look cute? Yeah. Got his hat going on there. Have a seat right down there, bro. There you go. All right, now this next young lady coming out, Anna. Look at her, she's huge. Little old Anna. Now this next fella coming out here, he's not an artist, but he is in his own little way. His name, Picasso. Come on, Pico. Hey, Pico, down here. There's only one left. Can you figure it out? Okay. And last but certainly not least, Miss Maddie. All right, now, folks, how many of y'all seen pig races? Raise your hand. How many of you seen a dog chasing a mechanical rabbit around a greyhound track? Well, we don't have any greyhounds. We don't have no pigs. What we do, come dinner time, they're all pigs. We don't have, we're going to have us a different kind of race today. We're going to race us with two Chiweenies. We're going to put the two Chiweenies together. Right on up there. There you go. Let me hear it for Sophie. Let me hear it for Anna. Y'all think Anna's going to win? They think the little one's going to win this one, Jimmy. I'm going to be nose to nose. Fair race, okay? Are you ready? On your marks. Get set. Go! Let me hear it for Sophie. Anna! Whoa, 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 what's going on with Anna over here? Anna! Hey, y'all know why Anna won, right? Anna's a smart one. She took the shortest distance around the track. Sophie took the long way. Come on over here, Soap. Folks, we want to thank you for coming out to the Ben Salem Fall Festival and coming to see the Country K9 Show, for those of you that are interested.
Racing is a game where friends and family drive laps around a scaled-down racetrack using remote-controlled race cars. What's going on, OTN? I am here with
Ed Cunningham
at the NASCAR Racing Game. I don't know if that's the exact title.
Rock and Roll Racing.
Rock and Roll Racing. That's what I like to hear. At the audience, we do have a very high demographic in ages and race, ethnicity, and it's really nice to see. So thank you for bringing everybody together in such a wonderful way.
Sure, my pleasure.
Ed Cunningham's creation costed over $10,000 to build and maintain every year, from the racetrack to the RC cars that bring it all to life. This year at Pride Day, a mobile arcade cart came rolling into town where children were able to play their favorite video games on the Wii, Xbox, and more.
mobile arcade ride is actually a million-dollar franchise sponsored by companies such as Nintendo and Microsoft.
So everyone, please stand.
Yo, Drew.
Ms. McDermott?
Sweet.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at this twilight's last whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting star-spangled banner yet waved o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Introduce to you the leader of our community and the leadership of our community, Council, Mayor DiGirolamo.
It says the Fall Festival Community Pride Day, Service Beyond Self Award. And this is an appreciation for all of your continued support and dedication to Bensalem Township. We present this to you, Ron, because from the bottom of our hearts, and Council, and everybody working as a team here in Bensalem, know what you do for us, and you're an incredible human being. He's a man that believes in his family, community, and I know he believes in God because we pray together. And I present this to you today, to you and your family that's up here, and you have to say a few words. God bless you, my friend.
Well, thank you so much. I am humbled and humbled by this award. I want to thank my family, Taj, my beautiful wife, his friend Matthew, for being here with me to accept this. But each one of you has a role in this because we try to connect and engage with you. And from the bottom of my heart, service above self, as we said, but we believe in service, we connect with service. But thank you so much, Mr. Mayor, thank Council, thank each one of you. I want to say one thing. When you get tired, don't quit. Don't quit, because when things go wrong, as they sometimes will, when the road is going, seems all uphill, when funds are low and debts are high, and you want to smile, but you just sigh. When care is pressing you down a bit, rest if you must, but don't you quit. Life is filled with twists and turns, and those of us sometimes learn that many a problem turns about, and he might have won had he stuck it out. Don't give up the fight, though the pace seems slow. You might succeed with another blow. Success is failure turned inside out. The silver clouds and tent of doubt. And you never know how close you are. You might be so near and seen so far. So stick with the fight when your heart is hit. It's when things seem worse, you must not quit. Thank you.
Thank you, everybody. Let's rock today. Let's have a great day.
The Bucks County Cheerleaders. We're going to bring out the small girls first. Let's hear your support.
Woo!
Ginny Lee Dance Studio. When do you see their...
Tools. Well, thank God I'm a country girl. Yeah, city folk jumping in a Live a good life, play my fiddle with pride. Thank God you're a country girl. My daddy taught me young how to hunt and how to whittle. Taught me how to work and play a tune on the fiddle. He taught me how to love and how to give just a little. And thank God I'm a country girl.
Senior demo team from Feasterville. I wouldn't mess with them. No B-Town Rumble.
We'll be right back.
We have the Primetime Divas. They got to get a little chance to set up, and they'll rock your world.
Yeah. Say it again. I said, nah, 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 nah. Who's that knocking on my door? All last night and the night before. Boom, 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 bang, bang, bang. I can't stand that awful clang. Who's that knocking on my door?
Stars. I'm gonna give